मैडम डिप्टी चेयरमैन द जवाहर रोजगार योजना एड्रेसेस इट्सेल्फ टू द नीड फॉर एम्प्लॉयमेंट गारंटी इन रूरल इंडिया आ प्रोग्राम विद सिमिलर ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अर्बन इंडिया द नेहरू रोजगार योजना एज द अर्बन काउंटर पार्ट ऑफ द जवाहर रोजगार योजना ऑलरेडी मोर देन अ क्वार्टर ऑफ आवर पॉपुलेशन लिव्स इन अर्बन सेटलमेंट्स द इंसिडेंस ऑफ पॉवर्टी इन आवर टाउन्स एंड सिटीज इज नॉट वेरी मच lower than the incidence of poverty in the countryside. Indeed, the problem of unemployment is as pervasive in urban settlements as in rural areas and in many ways more complicated. The complications arise on account of a number of factors. We have to strike a balance between providing wage employment in urban settlements and preventing a flood of unskilled labor from rural to urban areas. Fortunately, the Jawahar Rozgar Yojana is so effectively tackling the problem of unemployment for unskilled labor in the countryside that it has now become feasible to plan for employment guarantee programs in urban settlements while striking the right balance between the rural employment program and the urban employment program. The Nehru Rozgar Yojana will be administered by the Nagarpalikas who, as in the case of Panchayats under the Jawahar Rozgar Yojana, will be left free to choose what schemes to execute to identify the beneficiaries and to organize labor cooperatives of the urban poor to undertake the program. Guidelines will of course be prescribed. Reading the types of projects from among which the Nagarpalikas might make their choice as also in regard to the financial and technical norms to be observed and the methods to be adopted for hiring labor. We shall make it indubitably clear that neither contractors nor public works departments shall be involved in this work. We hope the Nagarpalikas will pay particular attention to identifying projects that are useful to the community as a whole and in particular to the disadvantaged and weaker sections of society. We are instructing them to especially target at scheduled caste and scheduled tribe beneficiaries in proportion to their population as also to facilitate 30% employment opportunities for women seeking employment. For larger urban settlements, there would be difficulty in merely replicating the Jawahar Rozgar Yojana model. For one thing, the materials component would rise too high for the accent to be placed firmly on employment generation per se. minimum wage rates in larger towns and cities are so much higher than in rural areas that the same amount of money would generate far fewer jobs while at the same time attracting large numbers of job seekers from distant rural and mofussil areas who should really be looked after in their homes or in the vicinity of their homes. Also, fewer jobs for the same amount of money would mean the spread is thin in precisely those urban concentrations where the numbers looking for jobs is much higher and moreover charged with higher expectations. We have therefore decided that the second component of the Nehru Rozgar Yojana should comprise a scheme of generating the required employment through a special thrust to housing and shelter upgradation in all towns and cities with a population in excess of 1 lakh. We are, however, excluding from this scheme the 4 super metropolitan cities of Mumbai, Kolkata, Delhi, and Chennai, not because these super metros do not need housing related employment, but because there are already in operation in these cities similar programs with investment running to hundreds of crores of rupees, including funding by the World Bank and other external sources. Thus, the Nehru Rozgar Yojana component for urban employment through housing and shelter upgradation might be seen as the extension of the concept of employment through house building and shelter upgradation to the hitherto somewhat neglected smaller metropolitan and non-metropolitan cities and towns of our country. Under this component, we have focused on the most labor-intensive activity available in urban areas, namely the construction and upgradation of dwelling units and housing. Besides the shortage of housing in these areas is too acute that the fruits of intensified construction activity will directly reach those most in need of it, that is the urban poor. Besides, housing requires so many different skilled trades such as plumbers and carpenters and so many micro manufacturing units such as for bricks, tiles and furniture, as also services such as transport and wayside dhabas and tea shops, that the employment generated is not only direct employment in construction but also secondary and tertiary employment closely associated with construction activity. Also, some of the house building and much of the shelter upgradation will be undertaken by family labor. The family is gives the opportunity of doing so by being given access to institutional finance.